In this video, I'm going to cover the newest updates to OBS Studio for version 0.15 that just released July 7th, 2016. We're going to cover the Image Slideshow, new video source, scenes within scenes, and more. Let's get right into it. This update to OBS Studio gives you almost no reason to still be using OBS Classic. I really recommend watching this video all the way through if you can. Now, if you haven't already, head over to obsproject.com, click download, select OBS Studio, and then click the OBS Plus Browser Source button. Once downloaded, go ahead and install it, and now let's check out the changelog. I'll walk you through all of the latest changes. First is the addition of the Image Slideshow Source. This is something a lot of people have been requesting. It's very simple to use and can be extremely useful. I'm going to open up OBS Studio 64-bit, and then under Sources, I'm going to add in an Image Slideshow. You can see that the options here are what sort of transition we'd like to use, the time between slides, aka the pause time for each slide, and the duration of our transition speed. These are in milliseconds, meaning 1000 equals 1 second. We can also select the option to randomize playback, which will play the images we'd add in a random order. Let's go ahead and click the plus icon to add in some images. You can add specific files or even a directory, which will automatically find new images you place in a folder. You'll need to restart OBS Studio if you add or remove any images into your directory for these changes to take place. Now, personally, I prefer the directory or folder method since it makes it quick and easy to update the images you want in the source. Now, most people can use this for something like a social media slider or even advertising and sponsor rotating images. Other cool uses would be something like an image slideshow of fun moments from your stream, etc. Now, anyways, with your files added in, you'll see the source is added into our preview area, and the width and height of it is dependent on the size of your actual images. We can, of course, scale it up or down as normal by just clicking and dragging. The next major change is the addition of the VLC source, which gives us the ability to add video playlists. In my opinion, this is pretty amazing. Before you get confused on why this source might not show up though, let me explain that you need to do two things. First, you need to make sure to install VLC on your computer. VLC is a great media player and I highly recommend it. Second, you need to make sure that you open up the correct OBS Studio to run this source. This will be the same bit version of VLC that you installed. So if you're like me and you installed the 64-bit version of VLC, you need to run the 64-bit version of OBS in order for this source to work properly. However, if you installed the 32-bit version of VLC, then you'll need to run the 32-bit version of OBS Studio. If you're not sure which version of VLC you installed, then just simply run both versions of OBS Studio and then try to add in the source and see if it's there. That's pretty much the easiest way to figure things out. By default, you might be opening up the 32-bit version of OBS Studio. Now, newer PCs run on 64-bit, so more than likely you will need to open up OBS Studio 64-bit since you probably installed the 64-bit version of VLC. For me, the easiest way to do this is to type OBS Studio into my search bar and select the 64-bit version here. I also recommend creating a shortcut for this on your desktop as well. Now, if you're confused here, let me know in the comments below and myself and some great viewers will try to help you out. Anyways, if you open up the proper version, you'll see the option to add in the VLC video source. There's an option at the top to loop the playlist, and then there's also options for visibility behavior. These basically decide what to do with your video when you're not on the scene that has your video source added in. So you might want the video to pause when you switch scenes, and then you might want it to resume where you left off when you go back to that scene. Or you might want it to stop completely and start from the beginning once you switch scenes as well. You can do all these right here. Just like the image slideshow source, we can decide to add in files or directories. For this time, I'm going to add in some files. I'll add in our animated Overwatch overlay and then another video that we made here. And then the reason I wanted to add in this overlay is to show you that this has support for .mov files and much more. This means videos with transparency or ones that have see-through pixels can be used here. So I thought that was pretty cool to show off because it opens up a lot of possibilities for things that you can do with your stream design. And then anyways, once the video is done playing, it will actually move on to the next video. And then once the whole set or playlist is done, it will loop back as expected. Something like this has me pretty excited personally because it opens up a lot of possibilities for stream designs. Now, while I'd like to go through most of these changes, let's actually skip ahead a bit. And then we're actually going to show off the next biggest change in my opinion. The ability to add scenes within a scene or sceneception is pretty awesome because you can basically set up reusable scenes somewhere and then add them into the different scenes that you'd like to actually use or display on your stream. For example, let's say that you're going to reuse an overlay with multiple sources, images, and alerts. You can just put that instance in a scene and then add that into other scenes. Anyways, let me give you an example to make this a little bit easier. I'm going to go ahead and make a new scene, and I'm going to name it something like Reusable, and you can, of course, name it anything that you like. Now, in this scene, I'll add in some images and maybe another source or two. Once I'm done adding these all in, I'm going to then position them exactly where I need them. Now, I can go back into scene 1 and then go and add in a new source, and I'll hit Add Scenes. I'll then select the Reusable scene to add it in. You'll see that everything from the reusable scene is now in scene 1. The really cool thing here is that first, I can move and resize this as needed. It's just simply grouping them together. Now, this can be very useful for people that are setting up scenes that require rescaling and precise adjustments to multiple sources. Second, if you ever need to, you can go back into the reusable scene and make any adjustments as needed. Once you go back into scene 1, you'll see the adjustments for positioning or whatever you needed to do are automatically applied. This will work with adding in or removing new sources as well. This might be slightly confusing, but trust me, it's pretty awesome if you can do this and use it properly. Okay, so let's go back down the line of the updates, and the next change I want to talk about is something that's pretty simple, and it's under Settings, General. We'll now see the option to hide the cursor over projector. Now, you probably won't use this too much, if not ever, but if you want to project your scene into a full screen setting on your display, then you can do that here and then the cursor won't show up. Anyways, the next option that we have is the view option at the top, and this actually allows us to customize OBS Studio's UI a bit if we like. So this can be pretty useful if you need it. Another option is to set sampling for resizing of a scene. Now, this won't be too useful for most people as well, but it can be found when right-clicking a source and going to scale filtering. It simply adjusts how resizing of a source is handled, so more than likely you'll want this to be on disable, which is its default. Another cool option in the settings under the general tab is the ability to go ahead and start recording when you hit start streaming. So if you tick this box, you're going to automatically start recording as soon as you hit the start streaming button. The other significant changes we have from this changelog deals with removing sources, changes to recording, and how GIFs or GIFs are handled. You can now select multiple sources at once and remove them at one time. To do this, all you need to do is hold down Control and then click the different sources and then simply hit delete or remove. And then each of the selected sources will be removed. This might be something that people think is pretty small, but I've actually ran into this problem a lot, so I'm happy to see this. Another way that you can select multiple sources is by first selecting one and then holding down the shift key and then selecting another that's lower. So if you select one that's a couple lower, it will actually select all the sources in between when you hold down the shift key. Now, when you hit stop record, it should also no longer cut off the video at the end, and this applies for stop streaming as well. It should stop where you hit stop stream or stop record. This is just another quality of life change that I think is pretty nice because for me personally, I've had to do some retakes when it comes to recording. Now for GIFs or GIFs, they now restart from the first frame whenever the image source appears. Nothing big here. So finally, there are a couple of bug fixes that you can check out if you like. Overall, I hope you see how useful this update is and how there's almost no reason to continue using OBS Classic. the major change of adding in the image and video playlists were something that people have been commenting about in my videos for a long time, so I'm really happy to see this addition. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything missing from OBS Studio, or if you found any parts of this video confusing and you just need some clarification. If you guys have any ideas for future videos, please make sure to leave them in the comments below. It's something that I always appreciate seeing. It really helps to know what you guys are struggling with or just what you want to know more about. Like this video if you found it helpful and make sure to share it with any of your friends or favorite streamers that are still using Classic. Also, for more great streaming and video game related content, make sure to subscribe to Nerd or Die. Thanks for watching.